What's up, peeps? It's Dr. Talbert here again for another video. Today I was going to talk about residency interviews and my approach to the residency selection process. So stay tuned. For me, when I was considering where I wanted to do residency, the first thing I thought about was the type of program that I was attracted to. So, you know, for me, I was looking for a laid-back program, a program where the residents are friendly with each other, where the staff are fun but also teach, and where you see a good mix of patients. Of course, for you, that may be different. Some people like programs that are more formal in nature. For example, one program that I know of requires all of their residents to wear suits on rounds every day. That may be the type of program that you love. Other people like programs that are very research focused, that will get you tons and tons of experience in terms of research and clinical trials. What program fits your personality and your style of learning and the things that you want out of residency the best? In terms of location, I am from Louisiana, in case you don't know. So I mainly applied to programs in the southeastern part of the United States. So I applied to some programs in Texas, Louisiana, of course. I applied in Alabama, I applied in Florida, Tennessee, the Carolinas, and I also applied in Nebraska, that's where I ended up, and also in Ohio. A part of thinking about the location is considering the cost to get there and the time to get to that particular residency interview. For example, I was in Louisiana. I could easily drive to Texas and be back to my med school responsibilities in a relatively short period of time, whereas other places require you to fly. And when you consider fly, you have to consider the cost associated with flying. You also have to consider the cost associated with hotels and gas and basically everything that comes with the residency interviewing process. The other thing that you have to consider with location is what your family thinks. And, you know, I'm more so referring to your significant other, your spouse, your kids, if you have those, because they will be affected by this choice as well. Whether they move with you or they have to commute to wherever you end up for residency. When I was doing my interview process, I approached each interview looking for pros and cons of the program that I could later discuss. And what I found though, as I went to more and more interviews, is that a lot of the pros were the same and a lot of the cons were the same. So for me, it really came down to the gut feeling, for lack of a better term, that I got when I was at the program. You know, looking at the staff that they have, the residents that they have there, how happy are the residents, how enthusiastic is the program director? Do you support the program director's vision for the residency? While you can change residencies, it's not the easiest process. So it's important to try to get it right the first time. I think above all, one of the most important things to do is to keep an open mind. I know for me, I was dead set on ending up in Texas. I had already selected my program before I even visited it. I had, just dreamed about living in Texas. And once I interviewed there, I realized that that particular program was not the right fit for me. And unfortunately, I wasn't going to end up in my so-called dream city. So, you know, without an open mind, I wouldn't have ended up in Omaha, Nebraska. So go to every interview and give them a chance. Evaluate them with a fresh mind, talk to the people there, and figure out if that particular place will be a good fit for you. And you may end up in a place where you did not expect. And that's okay. And that could be really good for you and your family. And yeah, that's good. Fast forward 3 years later, I'm approaching the end of residency. And it really gives me a lot of insight into, you know, what you want out of a residency and what things to consider. You want a residency where the program leadership will listen to residents and implement changes based on resident feedback. You want a program with a huge emphasis on teaching, a program where you will end up being a good physician, which of course is the number one goal. You want a program where you can be friends with your classmates because that just makes residency easier. You want a program that cares about you and your family and your happiness and your wellness. Those are the things that are important. And those are the things that will help you to become the physician that you are destined to be. If you have any questions about the residency process, my particular process, choosing a residency, or questions about medicine in general, make sure you leave a comment below. And of course, as always, hit that like button and that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.